Teacher cohort here from my wonderful school in Revere. I've been taking a year off to study music here at this wonderful program at the New England Conservatory, and my final project is this recital, and it's really an honor to have such a wonderful audience here to perform for you tonight. So we're going to be doing a little tour tonight with composers from different periods in time. That was Mozart, which I didn't want to introduce because I just love the way this begins, and I didn't want to wreck Mozart by talking at the beginning. Mozart, I think, needs no introduction and sounds best just playing right off the bat. So that was Mozart's Sonata in A Major. Next up, my music's gone. But next up we have, this first. Next up we have a piece by a Polish composer and violinist by the name of Henry Wieniawski, from the mid-Romantic period, mid-1800s. The piece is called Légende, and has a really wonderful story that I think really speaks to the character of the piece. The story behind it is Wieniawski had met the love of his life, Isabella. He fell in love with her, and he asked her parents for her hand in marriage, and they said no. They felt that at the time, being a violinist and a composer was not a steady enough living, and said, no, this, you're not fit for our daughter. In his despair and love, he wrote this piece for Isabella and dedicated it to her. The legend of the piece Légende is that when the parents heard this piece, they understood the extent of his love for their daughter and also understood the extent of his talents. And after that, they agreed and granted him her hand in marriage, which he did marry Isabella. So I think that tells you what you need to know about this piece and what this piece is all about. It's about despair and love, and while this piece may not have triumph, we can know that at the end it did lead to that for Wieniawski.
Thank you.
So next up, we are going to be taking a step back in time, back to the Baroque period. We're going to be playing pieces by two big giants of the Baroque period, first Handel and then Bach. First, let me speak to the Bach. That's going to be after the intermission, but I'm not going to introduce that when it comes. But the Bach is a Bach partita, which I'm very excited to play because my whole life I've wanted to play a Bach partita ever since I was 12 years old. My father, who's here tonight, took me to see Itzhak Perlman in concert, and he played the Bach partita in D minor. And I absolutely fell in love with it. We used to listen to recordings of it at home, and I asked my teacher at the time if I could play it, and she said, no, that's not really an appropriate piece for you at the time. But I played it anyway. I got the music and tried to work on it, but I never got to perform on it or work on it with the teacher. So I'm excited now, 35 years later, to be playing a Bach partita in public with the blessing and support of my teacher. Now this is a different partita than the one I listened to growing up. The one you're gonna hear after the intermission is in E major, which the one I listened to growing up was a very sad and achingly beautiful partita. This one is very exuberant and very bright. So stay tuned for that after the intermission. Before that, we have a sonata by George Friedrich Handel, the other big giant of the Baroque period. This was one of his last pieces of chamber music that Handel wrote. Certainly one of his most renowned, and it's really known for its majestic quality. That's something I think of when I play this piece, is just thinking about, now Handel was a court composer, and I think this really brings that image to our mind of being in the court and something very majestic. There are things he does with the notes and with the melody that really bring out that wonderful sense of grandeur. So, Handel Sonata, hope you enjoy it. actually have my watch off because I know that it makes light all over the audience. Does anyone have the time?
Yes.
Okay, so let's reconvene. We will start right at 9 o'clock sharp.